Two star good video too.
Yeah, I don't. I use mainly the curve. You got a curve there?
The bowl.
Yeah, yeah. We use a bowl for works too. Just because the customer's like, I'm buying a BlackBerry. I want to put alert and assist on there. So let's get started.
Sure.
And just go through a few things. So I know I missed this morning's sessions. So can you give me a little bit of background on the sessions this morning? What types of things were happening this morning? So we can translate it to something for our readers to take a look at.
Yeah. So this is the 26th city on the BlackBerry 10 Jam World Tour.
Okay.
And we kicked off the tour after the Orlando BlackBerry 10 Jam event. That was a 3-day developer conference, the one where we unveiled the BlackBerry Dev Alpha device.
Okay.
Incredibly well. And after that, developers told us that what they wanted was for us to take that tour, or take that content and bring it to them where they were. So we've been on 4 continents, 26 cities so far over the last 3 months, taking it through Asia, South America, North America, Europe, stints in Africa, Eastern Europe. We had an event over in Moscow. It was all over the place.
Okay.
And the format's pretty simple. The morning consists of a keynote presentation which talks about the BlackBerry opportunity and dispels some of the myths that people have about BlackBerry development. And then it dives right into, here's the BlackBerry 10 experience. We usually have a product manager or an evangelist give some demos. And then after that, in the afternoon, we split up into 3 tracks. A web track, a native development track, and here in North America, we've been running enterprise developer tracks as well.
Okay.
At the end of the day, we all get back together. We do lightning pitches at lunch, and the judging for the lightning pitches happens at the end of the day.
Okay.
People walk home, some of them, with Dev Alpha devices, because we have an application process that you apply to be one of the Dev Alpha developers, and then what we do is we take those devices and hand them out at the end of the day as the developers who qualify.
Great. So since we're sort of a gadget and technology blog, we have a lot of consumer followers.
Yep.
How much can you reveal on the with the new devices and the new sort of BlackBerry Alpha, what is offered to the end consumer? That's sort of what I'm looking for.
Well, I mean, a lot more of that's going to be revealed over the next few months. But what I can tell you is that we've done an awful lot of work interviewing people who are BlackBerry users about what they find special about BlackBerry. And we learned some amazing things. I mean, BlackBerry users are, for example, way more social than on any other platform. BlackBerry users send more messages on social networks. They communicate more frequently. They're more likely to use the device on a daily basis for that purpose than on any other platform.
That's really interesting. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's an interesting result, but it's also it's something that sort of informs the way that we think about the design of these new devices, right?
So we're talking more tweets, more posts on Facebook.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
things on LinkedIn.
Those kinds of things.
Everything.
BlackBerry people are communicators.
Okay.
Right. They're communicators. They're productivity focused, they're concerned with success.
Right.
Success on their own terms, though, right? So we have everybody from politicians to athletes to actors, all kinds of people who are at the top of their game are BlackBerry users. When Usain Bolt won in the UK, the very first thing he said after he got off the track is, I got to send some BBMs to some friends.
Great. Great marketing.
Yeah.
Okay.
So when you see a BlackBerry 10 device, it's going to be familiar in lots of ways.
Okay.
It's going to be the kind of media and gaming device that our customers have been asking for some time.
Okay.
But it's also going to have the BlackBerry experience ingrained into it.
Okay.
It's going to be reimagined for this new form factor and for this new operating system. But it's going to be a great communications tool.
Okay.
We talk an awful lot about flow and the BlackBerry flow. The experience of you using a BlackBerry device is one where you move seamlessly from one application to the next. It's not one where you push a button to come out of an application before you can go into another one.
Right.
So the in-out piece of it's gone with BlackBerry, even today.
Mm-hmm.
And as we move to the BlackBerry 10 world, what you're going to see is that we've preserved that kind of user experience where you move from one application seamlessly to the next, to the next, to the next.
Okay.
Device itself has been designed so that it can be used very comfortably one-handed. It's got this gesture, this hook gesture that you use with your thumb to move from one application to the next, sort of peek from one behind one application to find out what has previously happened in the flow. It's got a keyboard, an on-screen keyboard that can be used very comfortably one-handed.
Okay.
And of course, because you know we know how much our customers love that QWERTY keyboard.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you. Yeah, if you move away from that.
No, there'll be a version that's specifically for customers who love the QWERTY keyboard.
Okay.
Yeah, as well. It'll have a that familiar BlackBerry keyboard that they'll be able to use.
Okay.
I think all in all, people are going to be blown away when they see these things.
Awesome. All right. Just looking at a little bit of research I've done here. Let's see what else I've got for you. Can you comment at all on the article yesterday in the Globe, I don't know if you saw it, about the slight fluctuations in share price after the whole Apple, Samsung.
It's way above my pay grade, man.
Okay. No worries. That's okay. No problem.
I don't even know how to think about it. I haven't spoken to anybody about it.
Right, okay. Yeah, no problem.
Like, yeah.
Yeah, no problem. You're mainly here to talk product.
Developers, that's what I...
I understand. We attack more from a consumer perspective,
sure.
So I'm going to put in stuff on the posts around this kind of stuff. Because as somebody who's, you know, obviously uses an iPhone but uses a BlackBerry at work, and there's 9800s that a lot of our customers use for work, you know, you have the touchscreen and you have the keyboard, right? Mm-hmm. So was there sort of are you aware of a conscious need to kind of, well, we've got to adopt the touchscreen model and still keep the keyboard, or was it just like, well, this is the way the industry is going with mobile devices? Maybe we'll go with touchscreen and QWERTY, because the BlackBerry is known for QWERTY, right? And it's one of those things where it's like you don't want to burn any bridges with your existing customer base, but you're also like, well, I see what iPhone is doing, I see what the Android is doing.
Yeah.
You know.
I just think actually it's really interesting because you know, my personal experience with the 9900 is that it's actually a better device with touch and QWERTY.
Okay.
You know, it's just more intuitive to be able to pick your finger up and point at icons on the screen for all kinds of things. But it's also easier when it comes down to actually using the device when you have to type a message or something like that to go to the keyboard, right?
Okay.
So I think it's a really good hybrid of the two technologies.
Okay. What else I can ask you? I don't have actually many more questions for you. Can you speculate at all in the future, you know, of the company? There's been so much in the press about, you know, where the company's going in stock price. And, you know, I know, and maybe we don't want to go down that road, but I sort of see it as, when I'm reading a lot of this stuff, it's like, are we just heaping unnecessary criticism on the company, you know? Or is it like, it seems to me like, I haven't seen these devices, but it sounds like from what I've heard today since I've been here, that there's a lot of optimism. You know, around
I think if you go around RIM, there's a huge amount of optimism.
Right.
I think if you speak to any of the developers that have come out and seen the operating system in action, the operating system, again, a massive amount of enthusiasm and optimism. And the big challenge, honestly, is to get that message out there to the rest of the world.
Yeah.
Frankly, you know, to paraphrase Mark Twain, the rumors of our demise are greatly exaggerated.
No, that's good. That's good, because it's important, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, as somebody who's, like I said, worked in a company that uses BlackBerry, but I use an iPhone. I've reviewed Android phones on our blog.
Yeah.
You know, I've seen the Windows and Nokia phones. I'm kind of the belief, and in the blog post I wrote actually yesterday on the Apple and Samsung thing was, it's good to have multiple platforms and competition.
Sure.
Right, rather than
one
company that makes everything.
Yeah.
And is like, especially, for, you know, we were on a radio spot last December here in Vancouver, and we had a couple of BlackBerries, and the radio host asked us, what about, you know, what about the future of RIM? And I answered, I'm like, well, You know, I don't want to see a Canadian company disappear.
But you know what? I mean, when I get asked these questions by our developers,
yeah.
I point out a couple of facts. Because the inevitable comparisons come up. They say, well, isn't this like Nortel? And they say,
well, that's exactly right.
Boy, isn't this like you know, Apple when they were on their last legs and they had to take $200 million as a loan from, you know, Bill Gates?
Right.
And the answer is, it's not like either of those situations.
Right.
Nortel was a Ponzi scheme. You know, bad accounting sank Nortel. They were in debt and going deeper into debt.
Right.
Apple was out of money. RIM has 78 million subscribers that pay for our products every single month.
Okay.
We have $2 billion in cash in the bank. We have an incredibly exciting product coming out in the first quarter of next year.
Yeah.
We have partnerships with 600 odd carriers around the world that are eager to see us succeed.
Right.
This is in no way like the situations that people want to paint for us.
Yeah, no, of course not.
Yeah.
Okay, that's about all I have. Thank you. And